So as a scientist, I just have a strong curiosity about the world around me. And then as an avid outdoor enthusiast, I love hiking and climbing in the mountains and seeing things in the mountains. Just the variability in snowpack, the amount of snow in one mountain range versus another, drives me to ask questions about why is the snow in one mountain range versus the other? Do we understand that? Can we understand how that may change in the future? So my job involves looking at water in the environment and trying to understand how hydrology may change in the future, trying to understand forecasting in the current climate so we can improve water resource managers' use of existing water resources. We have two projects that we've been doing recently at NCAR. The first of which has been evaluating existing methods for understanding how climate change will impact hydrology. The second of which has been developing new methodologies to improve our understanding of how climate change will affect hydrology. And both of these involve looking at taking climate model information, which is really too coarse to be useful for hydrology, and trying to get better information out of it so that we can run hydrology models and come up with a more realistic assessment both of how the hydrology will change and what our uncertainty of those changes is. Because a lot of existing methods take climate model precipitation, which is sort of spread evenly over a large area, and try to downscale it using relationships developed at individual points, very often they don't recreate the spatial variability in precipitation that we see in the real world. And this leads to downscaled precipitation amounts that are far too large when you average over an entire basin for extreme events. So one of the ways we've been looking at improving this is instead of using the precipitation data from the climate model, using information from the climate model that we trust a little more, such as the atmospheric flows, how much moisture is coming into your domain, how fast it's coming, how it gets lifted up over a mountain range. And we're doing that through a combination of high resolution atmospheric modeling, using a new simple weather model that I've developed that runs much faster than a full atmospheric model, but doesn't quite have all of the physics embedded within it. The type of research we're doing should benefit water resource managers because it will improve our understanding of future climate scenarios and how much water may be available in the future.